Okay, thank you, Dr. Northworthy. I'm going to be talking to you about another component of off-target movement of dicamba. And if we all take a look at this picture here, I know some of you are kind of around the end, but what we have, when we show this picture, most of the time, people take a look at this and think, well, that looks like a temperature inversion. But what we're actually seeing is a dust cloud created by a pickup truck that has driven across the turn row in the background, and this dust cloud is moving across this field. And so one of our thoughts was, and what the idea behind this trial is that if a sprayer had been applying dicamba in that field near or on that turn row, there is the potential for that dicamba to pick up with the dust and move along with that dust cloud. There could potentially be three sources essentially for this dust, just like this picture. We could have the dicamba on the actual turn row and a truck or a tractor or anything else moving along and picking it up. Could actually be creating dust by that sprayer. The sprayer moving across the field and picking up dust and dicamba moving along with that. Or I'm sure all of us have seen those dirt devils or those dust devils that can be created. It doesn't even have to be that windy to do so, or if the wind really picks up, you can feel being sandblasted in some of the sandier ground. Not here, obviously, but, you know, elsewhere. And so what we designed this trial to do is to see if we could try and simulate one of those situations to where we could see some movement from dicamba picking up with the dust. And so what we did is actually where you're standing, we applied a 12.5-foot swath. We applied a 12.5-foot swath to the road where you're standing on of Extendamax, and we treated it with a pound of the acre. We treated it both here, and then we skipped the white flags in the middle down this way to the north, and then on the other side, we also treated that road as well. And what we did up here is at each one of these flags behind me and then also down there, after we made the application to this road, we placed a bucket out here. And then we took a truck and started down by those flags closest to us going that way. Woo! I'm about to lose the easel. And then we made three passes with the truck going from north to south and allowed that dust to pick up, and we had a west wind, and that dust cloud picked up and moved all the way across behind me, and we watched it. It went almost all the way to those telephone poles. And so after we drove and made that dust, we went back, and 30 minutes later we picked up those buckets from each one of these flags so that the plants under the buckets weren't exposed to that dust. We came back about 12 days later and rated for injury along this, and what we did see is at various points throughout these transects we do see a little bit less injury where we had those buckets, and that indicating to us that somehow that dust is moving, the dicamba may be picking up with that dust, and then it is entering the plant. Dr. Northworthy is going to initiate some research up in Fayetteville to look at, okay, can we actually see the dicamba move in, or not see, but can we actually get the dicamba to move into soybean from a dew or any other kind of event that would moisten those leaves caused by that dust? So we're not saying that this is a major component of this off-target movement of dicamba, of these issues that we've been seeing here in Arkansas and everywhere else, but we were able to demonstrate that there is a potential for the dicamba to pick up in the dust and maybe move across the field. So that's all I really have, if pretty quick and short. If there's any questions regarding to what we did here, I'd be willing to take them. Yes, sir.
How far did the damage go?
So we have a graph here. It's on this last picture. So this was from this field. And again, this is from the application and then also caused by the dust, but we saw injury out to, it really started to dissipate after 90 feet, but we were able to pick it up out maybe to 160.
But that's gonna be a function of wind speed. It's also gonna be a function of how much area you treat. Really the distance it moves is somewhat irrelevant when you're only spraying 12.5 feet here on a road. This was not designed to try to determine is it moving 100 feet, 200 feet, 300 feet. It was just to try to understand was there potential to move it. We also repeated this study. Actually, the same time Chris put this study out here, and at the same time I was putting out a study at Mariana, the same exact day, the same exact time, and we had a 1 to 2 mile per hour wind, and we had dicamba symptomology show up, I believe it was 18, 20 rows in with a one to two mile per hour wind. So very little wind. We sprayed 12 and a half feet wide, similar to what we observed here. And it was main thing we were looking for, could we reproduce potentially what we were seeing in the field?
What was your rate of dicamba put on the road?
We sprayed a pound on the road.
A pound
on the road.